Very good morning to all students once again for class. Yes, 9th D. I have already written some points. Yesterday we discussed in details the content, what we are going to read and all. But in other words, I have written again for those who are absent or absent-minded. Fine. So let's see. Go through the points first, and then we'll continue reading. We have read page 100 and 101. Half of the page is done. So kindly change your seat, this boy. Yes, get up. Get up. Give him the space to go there. Sit with Gagan. But you can come here also first, just to get them. So I'll be keep on changing the seat. The moment you talk, your seat will be exchanged with the person who's not talking. And permanent changes I'm going to make now. Story of determination. Fine. Protagonist Santosh Yadav. The lady who conquered Mount Everest twice. Fine. Most of the times, women are considered physically weak as compared to men. But Santosh Yadav proved it that this is not the fact. Anybody can be physically strong. The moment you decide to be strong, you can be strong. So it's all the mind game. How you prepare yourself, how you prepare your body also. So as a child, when she was born in, okay, now I'll be checking your knowledge, whatever we have read yesterday. Fine. Your previous knowledge already checked yesterday. And let's see. Yes. Aman ke saath. Name is? What? Yes, Ridhima. Ridhima, tell me in which state, or you can tell the name of the village if you remember, Santosh was born. Haryana state. Can you name the village? Anybody can name the village? Yes, Bhavansh. Joniawad. Yes, sit down. Revari district of Haryana. So this is the exact answer. She was born and brought up over there. Yes, Ashna, please stand up. Tell me something about the childhood days of Santosh. What sort of, you can say, childhood she had, and whether she was in a very secure or conservative system, or she was living in a very liberated atmosphere. Parents were? Okay, firstly, tell me about, she belonged to a family of Dash. She belonged to family of? Very easy question this is. I do not expect you to keep quiet. Yes, yes, beta. Gurshan. Yes. Affluent. Landowners. I was just looking for the key term. Aapne bola hai? But maybe due to the mask, it was not audible to me. Okay, sit down. So when you speak, speak louder. Okay, because of the mask also, sometimes we're not able to understand. So she belonged to the family of affluent landowners. She was not having any problem related to economic problem, you can say. Yes, Arnav. How many brothers does she have? Nobody will speak, yes. And tell me whether her grand, when her mother was expecting, Santosh's mother was expecting. What does the grandmother say? When a saint came and gave blessings that it should be a son. What were the words of grandmother to? She? Yes, she said, I don't want, we are not expecting son, we don't want son. They were then, she got the blessing to get a daughter only, granddaughter. Sit down, very good. So this is the way you are listening to the teacher. These facts you should remember. Fine, that shows your attentiveness. Very good for all the students, for all the participation and online children. Basically, you can write in chat box. Yes, well done, Riyanshika. You are typing along with this. So now, we'll be reading that we have read so far that as a child, she was raised with no discrimination, no doubt, but she was different from others. Girls were supposed to wear ethnic dresses and all, traditional, typical, the children or the, you can say, girl child specifically. They were expected to wear traditional clothes. She used to wear shorts. She was not the other kind. Then when she completed her higher secondary, she wanted to study further in, yes, Yes, in other colleges and for higher education, she wanted to go. And she raised her voice against her parents that she has to get it. And at what age they would get? Yes, at the age of 16. Very good. At the age of 16, they would marry the girls off. And she was the one to raise voice that she's not going to get married. That is at the last option in her life. Firstly, she wants to settle down. She wants to receive education. So she left the home and went to Delhi. Fine. And she went to Delhi and she got herself admitted into. Yes. What was the name of that hostel? Firstly, she went to Delhi after completing her further education. Then she went to Jaipur. In Jaipur, in which hostel she was living? Kasturba hostel. And what was the view from the hostel? She would look, yes, not like this. Yes, Kasturba hostel in Jaipur, right, Priyanshika? Yes, beta, please. Aravali Hills, very good. So she would get a view of Aravali Hills and she was pondering and she was thinking and wondering that why villagers, she sees from the window that they go somewhere and then after a while they disappear. One day she herself went over there. She met a group of mountaineers. She was so excited and she asked them whether she can join them and they answered in affirmative. They said, yes, of course. She was so happy. So that is the way her career in mountaineering started. So now we're going to read further. Fine. Career in mountaineering and how she scaled success. These two points we will be reading. Now it is not given. Right. So 101, paragraph 6, I'm going to read. Then there was no looking back. All the children send me feedback here. I am gallery view. I'm just checking whether all of you are present. Titiksha, Riyanshika, just note down because your attendance is marked here, beta, on daily basis. Riyanshika is there, Titiksha is there, Harmeet is there. Jinka aapka feedback nahi aayega, wo absent hai mere liye. Theek hai? Raghav Duggal. Khyati, Shabad, Arush Arora, Kavya. Fine. Total 8 participants are there. Fine. So let's continue. Now Surveen is also joining. She's late bit, but Surveen has joined. Page 101, paragraph 6. Then there was no looking back for this determined young girl. No disturbance, please. She saved money and enrolled in a course at, underline beta, Uttar Kashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. Underline this name. She saved money and enrolled in a course at Uttar Kashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. My college semester in Jaipur was to end in April. But it ended on the 19th of May. And I was supposed to be in Uttarkashi on the 21st. So I did not go back home. Instead, I headed straight for the training. So you can see very well how determined that girl was. If you want to scale heights of success, you have to sacrifice a lot of things, even meeting your family. Everybody, waits for the holidays when they're living in hostel that we will be meeting our parents. But because she had to join on 21st and she completed her course on 19th, so she could not go back home. Straight away, she went to Uttarkashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. I had to write a letter of apology to my father without whose permission I had got myself enrolled at Uttarkashi. Now see, parents were knowing that she is there at Kasturba Hostel. Fine. But they do not know that she has opted mountaineering further. They were thinking she will be completing higher studies. She will come back. We will find a suitable match and marry her off. But she was having other plans. She got herself admitted into Nehru Institute of Mountaineering without the consent of his parents. Is it clear? Thereafter, Santosh went on an expedition every year. Expedition is journey. Every year she would go for expedition. Her climbing skills matured rapidly, quickly. Matured means she was getting better and better. Rock climbing and mountaineering is not that easy, which we assume it to be. You need a lot of agility, power, stamina. हम थोड़ा सा चलते हैं थक जाते हैं because we're not used to it. We people every अभी 5 मिनट के रास्ते में जाना है we start you know using activas and bikes and all. We are not habitual of walking because our body is not adapted accordingly, adaptive to the situation. So she was a tough girl. So slowly and steadily she improved her mountaineering skills. She became very good in that. Equipped with an iron will. Iron will is very strong willed determination. Physical endurance and an amazing mental toughness. She proved herself repeatedly. The culmination of her hard work. Culmination is beginning. Underline the word culmination. Beginning of her hard work and sincerity came in 1992. Just 4 years after she had shyly asked the Aravali mountaineers if she could join them. When she asked Aravali mountaineers from the view she used to get from the window, remember? So usne jaake pucha tha na, can I join you? Exactly after 4 years. Yes, beta. Physical endurance is, the power how much you can bear. Aap seh kitna sakte ho. Find your stamina also, but how hard you can bear the things on you. Find physical strength. Beginning. So you might be knowing he's into swimming. You might have competed at a lot of efforts and physical agility required in that competition also, in all the strokes. Find sports people, they can relate. We can also relate, but those who are into sports, they can better relate. Iron will is very strong-willed determination. Fine. So after exactly 4 years, in 1992, her hard work started showing, you can say, true colors. Santosh Yadav scaled Mount Everest at barely 20 years of age. 20 saal ki age. And you know, when lesser the age is, more power and energy we have. Jaise jaise hum 30s mein jaate hain, aur energy kam ho jaati. 40s mein jaate, it is the nature's law. When you are human brains, you can say, is most active till the age of 5, you know. 5 saal tak bachcha, he can or she can grasp so many things, but we do not teach them. They're very active, 5 to 6 or 7 age, fine. So, and when you are in your early 20s or late 20s, you are more powerful. You have physical strength, stamina also. Fine. So she was just 20 years old and she scaled Mount Everest, becoming the youngest woman. And underline, this is her achievement. Youngest woman in the world to achieve the feat. Fine. Feat here means victory. If her climbing skills, physical fitness, and mental strength impressed her seniors, her concern for others and desire to work together with them found her a special place in the hearts of fellow climbers. It was not her, you know, whenever you are into any competition, yes, beta, whether you are in any competition which requires physical stamina and strength, your mental fitness, mental health is equally important. Jahan pe aapke brain ne aapko bola that yes, you cannot win, you are losing it, you cannot do it, you are going to lose it. You have to give yourself reminder, I can and I will. You have to boost yourself by giving positivity. Fine, only then your body will respond. Our brain is our slave actually. Whatever instructions you give to it, your body responds in accordance. That's why they say never talk about negativity. Never say that I cannot do it. You can do anything. Those who are getting very less marks in particular subject, you can get higher or you can be the top scorer also. It's just up to you how you manage. Agar pehle soch ke baithoge, nahi, I cannot do it because all others, they are toppers. Yehi hai, aise nahi hota hai. I have seen drastic changes in students. Now we meet our students passed out. They were not very good in class. Your marks are not going to define what you will become in life. It is a moment. Sometimes you're not well. Sometimes you're not prepared. Sometimes you're nervous. fine. But what you achieve in life is not going to match with the marks, obviously. So do not give a label to yourself just after a term is over. Stop labeling yourself. Okay? You have to be very, very mentally strong. She was a very good person. Now let me tell you, as a person, Santosh Yadav, jo jitna koi mahan hote hai na, that person is the most humble also at the same time. Grounded hote hai aise log. Both of you are talking. Mask do not mean you're masking your lips and I'm not able to understand. It's quite audible. Second desk you're sitting on. She was very concerned for others. She used to, work in a group. Other climbers, other mountaineers, they used to love this trait of this girl, that she impressed her seniors a lot. She was very, you can say, strong mentally and physically, as well as she was having the values of working together. That's why she had special place in heart of others. Next page, page number 102. Jaldi se aajao. During the 1992 Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber. Now, what is the proof of that? We can say that she was a good at heart lady. During the 1992, underline this incident, Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber who lay dying at the South Col. She was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. There was one more climber who was not able to reach the destination, and a lot of chances of heart stroke are there when you're going at the above level, level of oxygen. Fine, so all are not able to bear it. So she tried to save the life of one of the climbers, but she was unsuccessful. But she gave her, yes, Peter. That site, they have just given the name of the place. She was unfortunately unsuccessful. However, she managed to save another climber, Mohan Singh, who would have met with the same fate had she not shared her oxygen with him. She was having, they carry their oxygen cylinders at their back. Because the more upside you go, the less level of oxygen decreases. One more climber was there. He also was having less oxygen. So she shared her oxygen at very risk. This is very good risk, heavy risk, that she could also lose her life. But she shared her oxygen cylinder with another climber. And Mohan Singh is the name, please remember. Within 12 months, Santosh found herself a member of an Indo-Nepalese women's expedition. Underline. Next step to success. 12 months. Bahut kam time hai ye mountaineering mein. Saalon saal lag jaate hai to reach a particular destination. She became part of Indo-Nepalese women's expedition that invited her to join them. She then scaled the Everest a second time. So when she became a member of that group, she again went with the Nepalese women. And she reached there for second time, thus setting a record as the only woman to have scaled the Everest twice and securing for herself and India a unique place in the annals of mountaineering. Annals of mountaineering, it means in this arena, in this segment of mountaineering, she could bring laurels. Fine. She brought name and fame to India by bagging this position, prestigious position of the only women who scaled Mount Everest twice, youngest women also. In recognition of her achievements, the Indian government bestowed upon her one of the nation's top honors, the Padma Shri. Padma Shri is the India's topmost honor award. She was given that. And see, at very young age, she received everything. And parents were saying, get married at the age of 16. Has she followed that path? Do you think she would have followed this? She would have achieved this? No, because we have a number of other responsibilities. Describing her feelings when she was literally on top of the world. Ab ye dekho, reach for the top, name of the chapter. She is literally on the top of Mount Everest and she's top on the top of her career also. She achieved Padma Shri. No any ordinary girl could have done that. Fine, I have written a thought today in the morning. Only people with extraordinary determination, even if you are ordinary, read that thought. Okay, ordinary people with extraordinary determination can achieve anything. So last paragraph, describing her feelings when she was literally on top of the world, Santosh has said, it took some time for the enormity of the moment. Enormity is bigness. Enormous hota hai big. Enormity is grandness. Enormity of the moment to sink in. Sink in means to feel it. Sink waise hota hai, doobna kuch, sinking. But here it means she's saying, when I was on the top of Mount Everest, it's such a big thing. It took me a moment to realize that this is true. Ek moment mein socha ki, okay, this is happening with me. It took a moment. Then I unfurled the Indian tricolor. Unfurled, she opened. Yes. Usne usko khola. She was having a rolled flag with her. She unfurled the Indian tricolor and held it aloft on the roof of the world. She was waving that flag of Indian tricolor, Tiranga. The feeling is indescribable. She's saying, I could not describe that, what I felt. The Indian flag was flying on top of the world. It was truly a spiritual moment. I felt proud as an Indian. Also a fervent. Fervent is having strong feelings. Having strong feelings. Environmentalist, Santosh collected and brought down. See, this is the biggest thing anybody can think of. Apne liye sabhi sochenge ki I will, you know, set a record and all. Not only that, when she read, this is the shame on humanity that they squatter the, they, you know, spread such filth and garbage. She collected and brought down 500 kilograms of garbage from the Himalayas. Wahan pe garbage kaise aaya? Other people, we people, whoever go over there for trekking and all, you might, many boys and girls these days, it's confession. They go to for Himalayas trekking ke liye ja rahe raaste mein apne chips and energy drinks with their carry. After drinking and they are just throwing it away. 500 kilograms garbage she brought down from Himalaya. So you can very well imagine. A person, she might have arranged, she, beta, now she was known for this thing. She might have arranged with the help of government or what, she scaled it first time and second time when she went, she might have noticed. She had that idea. When you have ideas, you can channelize it by any means. Yes. Yeah, you want me. She never worked for to get the name and fame. She wanted to do what she loved. Yeah, yes, right. So it was the passion. Any doubt to online children, beta? Is it clear? Send me feedback. Very good.